Hi. In response to my October 23rd video entitled, Am I Using Too Much Compost and Mulch? There were a number of comments that could be summed up by the phrase, there's no such thing as too much compost. This is something I've likely said myself in the past. So today I thought I'd try to give you a better idea of what led me to address this topic in a video. I decided to make the video in response to a viewer who suggested that too much compost could lead to a buildup of excessive nutrients in the soil, resulting in plant and soil health problems, as well as pollution of adjacent natural waters. As a reference, the viewer provided a link to Dr. Linda Chalker-Scott's article, The Myth of Soil Amendments, Part 3. Dr. Chalker-Scott's article focuses primarily on permanent landscape installations, but does briefly address annual vegetable gardens. Regarding vegetable gardens, the article states that the annual incorporation of compost makes sense here. However, one needs to have an idea of what the soil already contains before more material is added. It's hard to argue with this, especially considering how little most agriculture extension offices charge for a soil test. So I decided that in the spring, I'd have our soil tested to determine if the amount of compost we've been using has led to large nutrient surpluses, or if there are other issues that need to be addressed. Some of you might be thinking, wouldn't a large surplus of nutrients be a good thing? But this brings us back to the two problems I briefly mentioned earlier, plant and soil health problems and pollution of natural adjacent waters. To illustrate these problems, Dr. Chalker-Scott describes an organic demonstration garden in which a large quantity of nutrient-rich compost was added to the soil. Last fall, we collected soil samples from a local organic demonstration garden and sent them out for nutrient analysis. This garden had already experienced some soil and plant health problems. Every single one of the sites that was tested came back with nutrient readings off the scale. In large capital letters, the report warned, "Do not fertilize this soil." The excessive addition of nutrient-rich compost to this landscape contributed not only to plant health problems, but to nutrient loading of adjacent natural waters. Much to my surprise, the nutrient surplus and resulting problems occurred despite the fact that no additional fertilizers were used. Now let's talk about some specific plant health problems that can occur. In the case of the demonstration garden just described, the plants grew excessively lush vegetation, but put few resources into developing defensive compounds that would help the plants defend themselves against pests. And as a result, there were many pest problems in the garden. In addition, surplus phosphorus from excessive compost applications can result in nutrient imbalances. For example, too much phosphorus can interfere with a plant's ability to uptake manganese and iron, resulting in deficiencies of these minerals and leaf chlorosis. And as Stephen Legary and I discussed in our recent mycorrhizae video, excess phosphorus inhibits the formation of mycorrhizae, which assists plants in acquiring water and nutrients. Without mycorrhizal relationships, plants have to put more energy into establishing root systems and acquiring nutrients on their own. Finally, excessive phosphorus can lead to NonPoint source pollution. To quote Dr. Chalker-Scott's article, The Myth of Phosphate Fertilizer, excess phosphate will eventually find its way into waterways. Aquatic plants are most often limited by phosphate, and the addition of phosphate will induce algal blooms. Such blooms are always followed by increased bacterial activity, resulting in lowered oxygen levels and the eventual death of fish and other animals. So yes, there is such a thing as too much compost. Though we haven't seen plant health problems related to nutrient surpluses in our garden, the best way to determine if we can reduce our use of compost is with a soil test. Plants only uptake nutrients they need, so if the soil tests show nutrient surpluses, we can save time and effort by reducing the amount of compost we make and apply to the garden. We shall see in the spring. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.